Good morning, everyone. We especially welcome those who joined us here in our sanctuary that is air-conditioned. I understand it's going to be 98 degrees today, but those of you who are at home, I also hope that you're keeping cool, and we welcome you, all of you who are following us on Zoom. Oh, I see a visitor here. His last name is Marsh. The Tim Marsh is here. How wonderful to see you. Let me just not only introduce who is leading our service, but then I will give the announcements. Helping lead our service in the absence of Sonny, who's away, is our own Dan Olson and our own Harris Farrell. Senior moment, sorry. I'm Glenda Maurer, I'm glad I remembered that. I'm your liturgist. Our technical assistants today are Rama, Betty, Amelia, Daryl. And of course, we are being all led by our Reverend Dr. Fred Weidmann.
Cindy on voice.
Oh, Cindy Naur is our vocalist. I try. Anyway, let's remember in prayers Philia Banks, Hannah Basus, Constance Radu, Anne Sandiger, Betty Sheets, Dora Shia, Rosemary Wittig, Reverend Willie Salmon, and Ernie Searle, who will be having some shoulder surgery. Betty Sheets is now at the Forest Hills Care Center and would welcome a visit. Hannah Basus is home and would welcome phone calls and cards. Let's pray for strength for the family of Sophie Bick on the passing of her husband, Albert. And let's remember in our prayers Michael and John Indergaard as they gather in North Dakota for a memorial service for wife and mother, Fudiko. Announcement, looking to the future. On Saturday, October the 1st at 11 a.m., we are going to have a blessing of the animals, probably out in our churchyard. And you can bring any animal that leashed or caged as you wish and come and see others' pets. Join in the fun and meaningful time of blessing of the animals and prayer on behalf of the animals and our world. I see that we are looking for volunteers to help set up and take down and to assist with our two-legged and four-legged attendees. On Saturday, October the 22nd, we are going to be celebrating again with a group called Open House New York. It's going to be Saturday, October the 22nd from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. There will be a presentation and tour, and you can come as a volunteer and learn more that you didn't know about our church. There's many ways you can help to get involved in. The dear person spearheading this is our own Betty Chen. And now, would Reverend Weidmann please come and give us our opening prayer?
Let me add my welcome on this 24th day of July, 2022, during this summer worship season in which we celebrate God's Spirit and our Spirit. And a special welcome to those worshiping with us for the first time. Whoever you are, wherever you are on life's journey, you are welcome here. We gather together in the Spirit. We are one in Christ, and so let us pray. O God, bless us as we gather in this room and from all the points of light joining us on Zoom from around our neighborhood, our nation, and world. Bless this service. Bless all we do and say and sing and pray. Bless this new day as you bless every new day. and bless us with the same joy in and for life that your ever-creating and ever-recreating Spirit offers us. And let everybody say, Amen. Amen.
We gather to rejoice in our relationship with God, our Creator.
Revive us, O God.
We gather as people called to the community by and with our Redeemer.
Restore us, O God. Make us alive in Christ.
We gather open to new possibilities for a new day.
Revive us, O God. Make us alive in Spirit.
Our opening hymn this morning is Morning Has Broken. You'll find that in your Pilgrim Hymnal, page 38. We'll sing all three verses.
Please join me in the prayer of confession. I will begin. O God, we share your grief at the injustice and discord that rages among your children, often by those claiming to represent you. Give us strength and guidance to turn away from the norms of this world, the lure of self-righteousness, and the appeal of comfort over justice. Embolden us to know that another world is possible.
Empower us to participate in its creation.
Be with us in this time of silent reflection. And be with us as we sing.
Create in me, O clean, O God, and renew a right spirit within me.
My siblings in Christ, God forgives us even before we ask and calls us to fullness of life in Christ, with each other and with the world. The peace of Christ be with you.
And also with you.
Peace. Peace, Lord. Peace. 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 Peace.
Today's first scripture reading is taken from the Old Testament, the very first book, the book of Genesis, chapter 18, verses 20 to 32. Then the Lord said, "How great is the outcry against Sodom and Gomorrah, and how very grave their sin. I must go down and see whether they have done altogether according to the outcry that has come to me, and if not, I will know." So the men turned from there and went toward Sodom, while Abraham remained standing before the Lord. Then Abraham came near and said, "Will you indeed sweep away the righteous with the wicked? Suppose there are 50 righteous within the city. Will you then sweep away the place and not forgive it for the 50 righteous who are in it? Far be it from you to do such a thing and slay the righteous with the wicked, so that the righteous fare as the wicked. Far be it from you. Shall not the judge of all the earth do what is just?" And the Lord said, "If I find at Sodom 50 righteous in the city, I will forgive the whole place for their sake." Abraham answered, "Let me take it upon myself to speak to the Lord, I who am but dust and ashes. Suppose 5 of the 50 righteous are lacking. Will you destroy the whole city for the lack of 5? And he said, "I will not destroy it if I find 45 there." Again he spoke to him, "Suppose 40 are found there." He answered, "For the sake of 40, I will not do it." Then he said, "Oh, do not let the Lord be angry if I speak. Suppose 30 are found there." He answered, "I will not do it if I find 30 there." He said, "Let me take it upon myself to speak to the Lord. Suppose 20 are found there." He answered, "For the sake of 20, I will not destroy it." And then he said, "Oh, do not let the Lord be angry if I speak just one more. Suppose 10 are found there." He answered, "For the sake of 10, I will not destroy it." Here ends the first reading. Our second reading is taken from the Gospel of St. Luke, chapter 1, verses 1 through, 13. He was praying in a certain place, and after he finished, one of his disciples said to him, "Lord, teach us to pray as John taught his disciples." He said to them, "When you pray, say, 'Father, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come. Give us each day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, for we ourselves forgive everyone indebted to us. And do not bring us to the time of trial.'" And he said to them, "Suppose one of you has a friend, and you go to him at midnight and say to him, 'Friend, lend me 3 loaves of bread, for a friend of mine has arrived, and I have nothing to set before him.' And he answers from within, 'Do not bother me. The door has already been locked, and my children are with me in bed. I cannot get up and give you anything. I tell you, even though he will not get up and give him anything because he is his friend, at least because of his persistence, he will get up and give him whatever he needs. So I say to you, ask and it will be given you. Search and you will find it. Knock and the door will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives, and everyone who searches finds. And for everyone who knocks, the door will be opened. Is there anyone among you who, if your child asks for a fish, will give a snake instead of a fish? Or if the child asks for an egg, will give him a scorpion? If you then, who are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will the Heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him? The word of the Lord.
Now, Rama, can we get that slide for the first hymn back up? And good, I'm glad to see you all moving again. Can we get us singing the first hymn? I want everybody singing, those at home on Zoom, I want you singing too. And I'm really happy, Cindy, thank you, and everybody, because I think I heard recreation here. You know, Sometimes you're in church and everybody sings recreation. Like, I get it, we all want to go to the beach, but... So recreation, I like that, like recreation. Let's have at it again. Hey, why not stand up, huh? And let, if you're willing and able, and let's sing, we're gonna sing verses 1 and 3 again to start off our sermon here. Thank you all. Thank you all on Zoom. I could hear you singing too. I'll tell you what. Oh, all right. You already put it back. I was going to say, if you're willing, leave it up just for a couple of seconds so folks can look at it again. The first verse and the third verse. I want to dig a little deeper into where this song is taking us, at least where I hear it as I sing it, taking us. Where the song is taking us both in terms of the creation story and in terms of our lessons for today, and especially our gospel lesson. Switch it back whenever you want, Rama. From the top, morning has broken, like the first morning. What do you think about that? I know I've heard some of you say it. I've heard it from you, and I know some of you live this way, or at least try to. You've told me so. Every day is a new day. Every day is a new creation, or at least holds the possibility for new life, renewed life, new direction, a new understanding of God and yourself and the world. Morning has broken, like the first morning. Just let yourself go there now, the first morning. Now, let's not get too technical about it. I mean, the first morning of creation, at least as it's told in Genesis, there would have been nobody yet, at least no human anybody, to observe and experience what was going on. So it would be sort of like one of those, if a tree falls in the forest and there's no one there to hear it type of things. There'd have been no blackbird yet either. But enough. Not worry about timelines. Just let yourself go there to a fresh morning in God's creation, seeing and experiencing the sunlight and the wind and the rain and the dew and the water and the trees and the animals and the leaves and the grass and the hills, all the rest of it for the first time. Go there. Let yourself be there. And stay there if you can as we go on with the sermon. The song goes on all about this feeling, using the word praise three times, if I can count, in the first verse alone, and then it comes up several times in the rest of the song. Praise, elation, sheer joy, and the willingness and ability to feel and express that sheer joy. That's pretty much what praise is all about. It's what the hymn, the song, is driving at, and it's what a good life well lived is all about. Sheer joy in life and the possibility of life and living life new every day. Now, we get around to that line, blackbird has spoken, like the first bird. I'd love to spend a whole sermon or Bible study class on that one line alone. I don't think I've ever brought this up here at the church in the gardens, and if I have, it's worth repeating. The very first sentence in the Bible goes like this. Many of you know it. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless void, and darkness covered the face of the deep, while a wind from God swept over the waters. That's how most English translations have it, exactly like that or something close. And then it goes on, and God said, "Let there be light," and so it goes. And so life goes on and on until you get to us and everybody and everything going on now. Now, that bit in the first line of the Bible about the wind from God. Anybody have a guess what part or aspect of God that might be referring to?
Spirit.
Spirit. As I heard a few other murmurs, that's what everybody's saying. Holy Spirit, right, the wind, breath, ruach in the Hebrew, of God. By the way, it's a feminine noun in Hebrew. That's kind of fun. It's a neuter noun in Greek. I don't know what to do with that. But the Holy Spirit is he. Doesn't quite work if you got a feminine and a neuter. Now, and here's a big hint. We've been talking about and singing about birds, blackbird, first bird. We just talked about wind. What animal in the Bible is the Holy Spirit associated with? I'll give you one guess. Well, dove, I'm hearing. Yeah, good. And it is dove in one of the Gospels. Any bird will do. Bird comes up a few times for the Holy Spirit. And now here's where it starts to get really cool in terms of the first sentence in our Bible. That same biblical word that means swept over or moving over, when it's talking about wind, that same word when talking about birds, and it is used in the Hebrew language to talk about words. So I or anybody else who talks about this isn't making it up. When that word is used about birds and mother birds in particular, it means to brood, with all the connotations of caring and protecting, even moving and nurturing, and preparing your brood for the future that brooding means. So think of that for a moment. And it's interesting to think about that on this continent where mother bird plays such a big role in many indigenous creation stories. Think of it. Think of this sentence translated or interpreted this way. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth hadn't been formed yet and all was dark. So this is, notice, even before the beginning we're talking about. And there's this potential something, but not yet anything, there. And God's Holy Spirit, mother bird, was brooding over the whole thing. Wow. I just love the way our song hints at that. Morning has broken like the first morning. Blackbird has spoken like the first bird, like the Holy Spirit, brooding mother bird at creation. And like the Holy Spirit at creation, so the Holy Spirit now is here, in with and all around you, on this new morning, on every new morning, urging you, urging us, comforting and challenging you, comforting and challenging us, like a brooding mother bird, to go, to be, and to do in the world just what God has made you and called you and us together to do and to be in the world. Wow. And that, the preacher says as he starts to wrap things up, because time is against us, that brings us to our gospel lesson that we heard read, and to the Lord's Prayer that we heard read. When you pray, says Jesus, for your life, for your livelihood, for the living of these days, when you pray for the world, for ongoing creation and recreation of all that God has made, when you pray. And here's a hint from the Lord's Prayer itself: pray every day. It'll do you and the world good. When you pray, pray like this, Jesus says, and so we do here together in every Sunday worship service and at other worship services, and so I hope and pray you do every day. And when you pray, as you pray it, as you live out your prayer, do it like you mean it. Do it like you're with God's Holy Spirit, mother bird, on that first day. Because every day is something like that first day. Think about it. There's a lot of darkness and unclarity and unrecognized potential and lots of light just waiting to come. And God's Holy Spirit is somehow, some way, in with and all around it, and in with and all around you, brooding like a mother bird, caring for and nudging and nurturing you, available to you as you do your thing. And then one last thing I want to get into before we leave this. Just look at how prayer works and how life works. Look at what our lessons teach. If I had a dollar for every time Father Abraham says to God, suppose, just suppose, I think even at Starbucks I could afford a cup of coffee. Suppose 50, suppose just 45, suppose. And look at Jesus' words. He does the exact same thing. Suppose one of you has a friend, and you go to him, Do you suppose that God wants us to suppose? I suppose so. So take God and Abraham and Jesus up on the matter and start supposing about the future. Start following the Holy Spirit's lead and take it all in, the darkness and the kind of chaos and the light. Take in what's already there and what isn't here yet for you and for the world. And just suppose. Start supposing. What if? And with Jesus and the Holy Spirit leading and nurturing on the way, I suppose a lot of good and life-giving things can and will happen for you and for us together as church, as you and we together move through life, supposing and doing and praying like it's the first day, a fresh new morning. And as we look for God's creation and recreation in our own lives, and recreation too, and in our life together in the world. And so let all of God's supposers and doers and prayers say together, Amen. Amen. After you.
Yeah. Our second hymn this morning is Lord, Let My Heart. You'll find it in your green hymnal, page 79. Lord, let my heart be good soil.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, who is present in us, with us, and all around us every new day. O God, who calls us to see and to be and to live into a new future of light for our own lives and for the world. O God of prayer, O God of life. We thank you for all the freshness of creation and new life all around us. And we thank you for this dear faith community and for all of our partners in ministry and for all we do together to bring your light and your good news to our own lives and to the world. And we pray for all leaders and all people that they and we would be moved to live and to act in the way of justice for all. We pray for the people of Ukraine and for all faith and civil organizations working to bring necessary aid. We pray for all who are working for the ways that make for peace in that conflict and everywhere where hatred, fear, and violence threaten life and quality of life. We pray for our city and our nation for an end to gun violence and hate crimes. For an end to all the prejudice and hateful rhetoric that promotes and sustains such hate and violence. We pray for the health of our nation and its people in body, mind, and spirit. And for our own church family, we pray for Philia, Hannah, Jennifer, Connie, Anne, Ernie, Dora, Betty, and Reverend Willie. We pray for all recovering from illness and injury. And we pray for Rosemary and her family and all who care for her as she's receiving home hospice care. We pray for Sophie and her family. We pray for Michael and John and their families. We pray for all who are grieving the loss of loved ones or loss of any kind. And all other prayers, O God, we bring to you as we hold them in silence or as we call them out aloud now. Hear all these prayers, O God, and hear us now as we pray the prayer that Jesus taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive others. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Seated. As we move into a time of offering, Christ calls us to new life, fresh life, every day, and calls us to bring God's Holy Spirit light to our own life and to the world. What if, just suppose, we did that in our giving and in our living? Church in the Gardens family, we give from what God has given us to support the dear work of our dear church together, to spread the good and life-giving news of God alive in the world. Amen.
We thank all of you for your continued very generous support of our lovely church. And if you would like to donate today, there are four ways you can make a contribution. You can send your check to the church. You can set up bill payment through your bank to have checks mailed to the church. You could go to PayPal. I believe Zelle is the preferred method of using. And we also have an offering plate at the back of the sanctuary. Sweep over us. Please sweep over our world with your mighty wind and come into each person's heart and fill us with your love and your magic and your grace. Thank you for these gifts today. Please accept them. with our humble gratitude for all that you have done for us. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Excuse me, the last, thanks Harris. The last hymn, of course, is I Lift Your Name on High. It's in your green hymnal, hymn number 157. I was busy getting this out, sorry.
Many moving parts.
Blessing, just the thanks again to our musicians, Dan, Harris, Cindy, and Glenda on tambourine. And a reminder, I think fellowship and coffee hour is set up for us just at the base of the steps outside, so we'll gather there. Can we have the last hymn up? So we learned how to pray today, and how does the prayer start? By lifting God's name on high. And I hope we learned how to live today, live by singing God's praises. And I know we learned how to be a liturgist at the church in the gardens today. You forget what you're supposed to do because playing the tambourine is more important. And that's how to live life. So Lord, bless us as we live, and let's receive the ancient blessing. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May God's face shine on you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and give you and the whole world peace. Amen.
Amen. Amen. love to sing your praise.